Welcome back to Distant Shores. This time we're exploring the beautiful waters of the Bahamas. Last time on Distant Shores, we talked about volts, amps, watts, and the like, and how much power we use for all kinds of different parts of the boat. This time we're going to talk about how we generate power and how much power we need and where it comes from on board and how you can do it too. So this is a great time to be collecting solar power down here in the Bahamas. Anywhere between sort of 10 and 3, you're getting pretty high output as the sun is really coming overhead. We have 5 100-watt panels up here on this arch. The plan was to get the panels up above the deck and also provide shade in the back of the cockpit, as it's doing now, but also to make sure that there wasn't shade on top of the panels. It's one of the most important things, that the panels are always in the sun. Even a small amount of shade across a panel can reduce its output almost in half or even entirely. For just 10% of the panel covered, could cut 100% of the power out of it. Each of these panels weighs 8 kilograms for a total of 40 kilos, which is about 90 pounds. That's the weight of the panels. And then the arch itself weighs about 60 pounds. We wanted to put a lot of panels on would be great, but I didn't want to compromise the boat's performance by having too much weight high up and too big of a heavy arch on the back and windage and stormy conditions and stuff. A simple rule of thumb for how much power you can get out of a solar panel is roughly 5 times the value of the panel will equal what it'll produce per day. So you could say on average, if it's a 100-watt panel, you'd hope to get 500 watts for an entire day out of it. Obviously it doesn't work at night, and that just is a formula that sort of simplifies it for use in the typical sunny climates where we sail down south. And that gives you a rule of thumb for when you're planning what you're gonna get. It's really important to not have shade on the panels, and then you can hope to get 5 times the panel's output. Now I've got an app on my phone made by the panel controller that can tell you how much power we've got out of the panel. So it's showing that we're getting, say, 400 watts or so, and that we're getting a history back here that it shows you all of the past few days that we've got, how much power we've got out of the panel. So we know what we're producing. The last important factor for setting up a solar arch, I think, is to have a controller, because you do have to regulate the power that comes out of the panel to put that into the battery. So it's to match the voltages that are coming out of the panel as the sun goes up and the panel produces more, the sun goes down and it still produces enough power to go in the battery. So the best thing to do is to get a maximum power point controller. They're called MPPT controllers. They're a little expensive, but they make sure that you get the most power out of the panels into the battery bank. So today we're exploring out here in these shallow waters. We're just going to be moving to a new anchorage, and we're not using very much engine time, but that's going to do a fair bit of what we need for our power use. From last time's budget, we came up with a total power of sometime between 2.5 kilowatts and 4 kilowatts total power used. Today we're going to be generating power partly with the sun, as we've got a nice sunny day down here, and partly with our engine on-engine generator. It's the other way we generate power. And the on-engine generator can put out up to 6 kilowatts. At the moment, we're generating something like 5.5 or 6. And the rest of it, the power we need, will come from the sun. Now, the nice thing about such a big, powerful generator is it doesn't take very long to put in a couple of kilowatts, and then we get a couple more kilowatts from the sun, and that's all we need for the day. So we can get, even if it's 15 or 20 minutes, maximum engine running time as we're going to move around here in the harbor. That'll probably be enough. This has been another wonderful day in the Bahamas with lots of sun, so we've collected a fair bit of power from our solar panels. It seems like we get more than 2 kilowatts from them today. Now we've also run the water maker quite a bit, so our use is high, around 4 kilowatts. So we need about 2 extras. So what I'm going to do now is just start the on-engine generator. That'll give us the rest of the power. So now with the engine going, I can just set it to around 1200 RPM. And that's sufficient to generate up to 6 kilowatts. In that case, to get 2, I'll need to run it for about 20 minutes. That's all we should need to do. Now let's go and I'll show you around the components of how the on-engine generator works. The on-engine generator lives naturally on the engine. We've had the system now for a whole year. This is the heart of it right here. So that is the generator itself spinning on this nifty belt system running down there. And that can generate over 6.5 kilowatts of power. It doesn't have a controller on it. The controller is over here. Do you want to show them?
Sorry, I didn't know you were starting already. I was having a nap. Okay. This is the other part of the on-engine generator, the brains of the whole thing. This unit takes the power that comes out of the three phases of the generator and turns them into the right amount of current, and also very, very carefully checks everything about what the engine's doing, whether you're operating the engine in high speed, whether you've got it in gear, and uses only the surplus power so it never will overload the engine. That's totally critical. The only other component of this is the big old battery bank that can accept a really high rate of charge. So this system is extremely good if you're working with lithium batteries, or if you're working with batteries like we've got, which are thin plate pure lead batteries that can take a really high charge all the time. There you go. Thanks.
So there you go, solar power on board. And today we're going to average something like 2.5 kilowatts, and we're using maybe 3. So the fact that we ran our generator for just a few minutes puts in enough, and then the solar power finishes charging it up while I have a nap. Thanks for watching, and thanks to all of you who suggested this video series about marine power. If you missed the first 2 videos in the series, here are the links, and if you have any questions, I'd be happy to answer them in the comments below. Let us know what other topics you'd like to see videos about too, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss upcoming videos from distant shores.